genes, genomes, and DNA. These words have slipped into our daily news cycles and our awareness, but what they actually mean often remains unclear. In these lessons, we aim to give you not just the explanation of what a genome is, but a real-life perspective on why you already care about genomics, perhaps in ways you didn't even realize. What is a genome? A genome contains all of the information that a cell needs to develop, function, and reproduce itself, and all the information needed for those cells to come together to form a person, plant, or animal. Genomes contain an organism's complete set of genes and even tinier genetic structures that help regulate when and how those genes are used. The ability to regrow a torn ligament, the clues that might predict the onset of mental illness, the nutritional potential of crops, and even the history of life itself are all encoded in genomes. Genomics is a new science. It tries to understand all the genetic material that we have. The genes, as well as tiny structures that regulate where a gene is turned on. How active the gene is. And how it contributes to overall function. To begin in genomics, everything starts with DNA. DNA is the fundamental building block of all of life. DNA is a complex molecule. Think of DNA as a set of letters that form sentences, and eventually these sentences form paragraphs, and these paragraphs form whole books. So, we have DNA, and then we have genes that are made up of pieces of DNA, and then as we assemble all the genes together, we have our book of life, the genome. Genomics is very much technology-driven. We have benefited from an incredibly fast development of the technology. The core of genomics lies in sequencing. It has been amazing to watch the technology develop very rapidly over the last 30 years. It's not that long ago that we started with a very, very tedious process that was done in individual labs that took hours and hours to obtain a sequence of maybe 20 or 30 nucleotides or pieces of the DNA. Now it's possible to sequence an entire human genome, which is 3 billion such pieces, in a few hours. We've gone through several forms of technology, and we've also gone through changes in the organization of the science as a result. In the early days, everything was done in individual labs, contributing in small amounts to the sequencing that we were able to analyze collectively. Now we are moving more and more as the technology advances to centralized facilities with very expensive equipment that able to handle large amounts of DNA and perform amazing feats of sequencing. Genomics is not just based on sequencing technology. It has actually spawned a whole other area, which is called bioinformatics. Since genomics gathered such huge amounts of data, it's impossible to use conventional, statistical approaches, and general data organizing approaches to handle it all. As a result, we have a new breed of scientists, who is expert in biology, expert in computation, and to be able to bridge the gap and give us the tools we need to make sense of the data. These scientists, bioinformaticians, are incredibly essential to the whole genomics enterprise.